Peter. Hello, everyone. As Peter said, my name is Brent Rich with Riot Games. I was just in South Korea at our League of Legends World Championship that you saw at the end of the video, and it still takes my breath away. It is my honor to be up here today to talk about our journey behind what you just saw and how with AWS, Riot was able to supercharge our purpose to make it better to be a player. Now, at times, the story may seem like it's jumping back and forth, and things were happening all at once, and that's because they were. But with the help of AWS, we ended up doing it all, even when we had to change timelines or pivot priorities, and spoiler alert, it happened a lot. For me, though, it all started 5.5 years ago when I joined Riot Games. The thing is, back then, we were a single game company with all our eggs in one basket, League of Legends. And back in 2009, when League launched, it was completely reliant on colo data centers, which we managed because, let's be honest, we didn't trust that anyone else could meet our bar for making live games great. And that worked for about a decade. But by 2017, it was taking forever to get things done. And we knew that if over 100 million players worldwide didn't see Riot investing in and loving our own game, they would leave, even if it is free to play. So we started looking at options, and we quickly settled on going all in on cloud. That meant we would migrate to AWS, which had the broad set of services that we needed to run Riot. We also decided that all new things would be born in the cloud, and for us, that meant new games. Now let's pause for a second, because if you didn't notice, my intro stated that I work at a place called Riot Games, with an S, right? Well, that S was the next big opportunity in early 2020 to collaborate on with AWS, the global launch of VALORANT. VALORANT, a tactical shooter game, had very specific design goals, and one in particular presented a unique challenge which we were able to address thanks to AWS's global cloud infrastructure, Peeker's Advantage. Peeker's Advantage occurs when a player in motion can push the corner, knowing there is a split-second delay for the defender on the other side, which allows the peeker to see the defender first. And one way to address this in first-person shooter games is by adding more places for the defenders to hide, but that increases the luck and the chance of the game versus it being on the player's skill alone. And to us, that just feels bad. So we made it a priority to mitigate this in VALORANT. And we determined that at highly competitive levels of the game, if server tick rate is at least 128 per second, which requires a ton of compute, and network latency was under 35 milliseconds to players, requiring all those AWS locations, if those two things happen, peekers have no advantage. And if you're not familiar with how this technically works, in the game, player actions and movements are sent to the server. The server then updates and sends the simulation state of the 10 players back to all of them, and it does this 128 times per second across the internet. It's this speed of updates between all 10 players to the server and back again that effectively mitigates Peeker's Advantage and makes playing much more fair, which we hope is more fun as a result. And by using AWS, Riot was able to launch VALORANT globally with fairly low risk. We're able to provision a bunch of cloud capacity all over the world with no long-term commits, leveraging AWS regions, local zones, and outposts. This meant that if the launch didn't work out, we would simply shut it down and fail fast, and I'd go cry in a corner. And so after all of that, 2020 was great, right? Not quite, unfortunately. While we did have a massive success putting that S in Riot Games, the pandemic was causing havoc in the world of esports. All our competitions like Worlds had ground to a halt, and while games were doing great, esports had no new content for them. So we had a new problem. How could we reinvent remote broadcast and eliminate the need for on-site staff sitting in cramped trucks? Of course, AWS had a solution for that. We ended up enabling video encoding and production to happen in the cloud, with our folks accessing it through AWS workspaces from home. It was pretty wild. From a proposal to rollout, it ended up taking all of 11 days. And today, we've matured even further. We leverage AWS to remotely produce events all over the world, all from our remote broadcasting centers in Dublin, Ireland, and Seattle, Washington. This allows producers, editors, and casters to be in one place while all our events are at another. Okay, so now that we had esports back producing world-class competitions and VALORANT was successfully launched and doing amazingly, it was time to modernize League and migrate it to the cloud. But there were some challenges. Like first, we had to figure out how to safely deploy, configure, and test 30-plus microservices in a world where every service team was used to managing their services independently and how they wanted. And second, using Amazon EKS out of the box just didn't meet our needs, because some of our games can run on average 35 minutes, And we couldn't just pause or take a container out of service within 15 minutes if required for AWS maintenance. So we made a product ask, and AWS delivered a short-term solve, and then followed through with a long-term solution for us. But we also know there'd be some additional expected benefits along the way. And one was uptime. In the old days, when anything in a Riot data center failed in an unexpected way, it was often a large outage that lasted 1 to 3 hours. But once we got up and running at AWS, those outages instead turned to hiccups that players barely notice. And the other one was visibility. Anyone here ever spent an unreasonable amount of time trying to figure out what you have, how it's configured, and who consumed what for who? So did we. But with AWS, retrieving this data is pretty much now all an API call away. And so with all these challenges and benefits, what did we get for it? Well, we did migrate 14 data centers. We modernized a decade-old game for hundreds of millions of very loyal players around the world. We basically rebuilt the plane in flight. We modernized remote broadcasting, and we launched several global games in cloud over 36 months. It was a lot. Okay, as I wrap this up, I'd like you to remember that Riot didn't actually do anything groundbreaking here. When there were problems, we looked for solutions, and it just so happened that AWS had them for us. And so a quick tip, make the ask. It doesn't matter what size company you are. If it makes sense for the broader customer base, AWS just might do it. Or like us, there might be a short-term solve. And one final takeaway. When you're looking at cloud and whether it serves your needs, don't assume what was true 6 months ago is true now. Cloud moves very fast, and it's always changing. I know for a fact that we would have saved quite a few headaches if we were willing to reevaluate more often versus pursuing our own solutions. So please keep an open mind. And with that, thank you very much for listening to our journey, and I can't wait to see what AWS comes out with next. Thank you.